Welcome back. Now, that's a selection of hits that Marty Pella will be performing on his Private Collections tour, which dates in Belfast and Dublin in October.
The Brit and Ivor Novello award-winning singer-songwriter first came to our attention as the lead singer Wet Wet Wet, selling chart-topping multi-platinum albums with over 25 chart hits. His back catalogue includes, I'll breathe in here because there's quite a few, Goodnight Girl, Angel Eyes, Sweet Little Mystery. As well as that, he's had time to take over the airwaves during the summer of 1994 with Love Is All Around.
Yes, good morning, Marty. Hello, you're very welcome to Weekend AM.
Thanks very much for having me. Now, apparently, you know your way around a frying pan.
Apparently, yeah.
Now, do you need to be fed?
I thought to myself, I'll no bother having my breakfast because
you thought I'd cook for you?
You know, because I like a bit of cooking myself.
I hear you, son.
Do you know what? And I thought, no, I'll hold off. I'll come here and I'll get something.
Now, if
to eat.
I was
devastated that you've not got the frying pan.
Are you telling us you haven't had breakfast yet and you're relying on us?
I was going to soldier on. I thought I was going to get covered here.
If I was to rustle up a Scottish speciality for you, what would it be?
Why are you changing your accent there?
I don't know.
Always sound a wee bit bully calling. <on
them.
laughs> Oh, it's yourself.
What would you like?
When I would be here, I like a bit of fruit pudding.
Do you?
I like a bit of fruit pudding. I'm old school, I like a wee bit of black pudding.
Old school, yeah.
Yeah, you know, okay. And...
Have you ever had... Because you spent a lot of time in Dublin before. Have you ever had a cuddle?
Not a cuddle.
A clear stew, bacon, sausages.
Bring that stuff on.
Give me
I like comfort food.
Good man.
I like comfort food.
No one needs cuddle anymore, don't mind him. He's weird.
Listen, can I make an admission to you? One of the first 12-inch records I bought, because I'm that old...
Oh, I remember that Dickensian format.
Yeah, it was Sweet Little Mystery.
I love that song.
But the 12-inch, that was savage.
Well, that's it. You could get a good dance. And I know how much you like to, you know, snake hips that you've got there.
Snake hips.
We were busting a few shapes on the dance floor back in the day.
Well, I think we were all falling in love to your songs back in the day, to be honest with you. Or some people may have had your poster on their wall. I'm not sure who I'm speaking for, a friend.
Yeah.
But
yes.
Can we talk about Love Is All Around,
first of all, before
we get to the modern, current day stuff? Yeah. Because this was a song back in 1996.
94.
That stayed in the charts for a record number of
weeks.
It was like eating chocolate every day.
It went on and on. There was that time there was a few records like that, like the Whitney Houston one or the
Brian Adams.
And Love Is All Around was a prime example from that, from the movie Four Weddings and a Funeral.
Which Richard Curtis, I was fascinated to read this and I hadn't realised it until yesterday when I was reading all about you, offered you three different songs, is that correct?
He offered us a few songs. I think one of them was Can't Smile Without You with the Barry Manilow.
Yeah.
But when we heard the Love Is All Around, we thought, you know what, we can do something with this. And I remember singing it for Reg Presley, who was the gentleman who penned the song from the Troggs. And he said, I love what you've done with our song, Marty. And, you know, as a songwriter, that was a great compliment.
Absolutely.
And so I still sing it to this day. And I love R.E.M.'s interpretation of it too.
Yeah.
And that shows you the journey of a good pop song. It can be painted in many different ways.
Well, it's a good song, it's a good song.
There's so many different interpretations of it, isn't there? But is it true that you guys had it pulled from the charts at one stage because you were so fed up with it?
Well, we're kind of going like that. It'd be nice to give someone else a shot. Because that's a caring, sensitive guy. I would like to think it was some sort of... Some people say it is, was that some sort of market employee there, Marty? You know, I'm not that smart.
Yeah.
You know, so, no.
But the Wet 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 were a phenomenon, Mark, weren't they?
They some great songs, simple pop songs, you know? And I think that's a great testament to the songwriting.
But what you had was, and you don't really see it anymore, is just hit after hit after hit after hit. It was just you were in the trenches
there.
And you just kept going. The momentum kept going.
That's it. And I think a fan base that was very supportive and also quite brave in their choices of coming on journeys with us, you know, rather than saying, no, I just want you to just be like this. And I think that's, as you grow as a songwriter, then so should your audience. As you get switched on to different genres of music, that's going to work its way into your songwriting.
There would have been serious competition in terms of bands back then, like Simple Minds, Simply Red, U2 were at their pump, you know.
Aye.
And yet you guys were...
We just kind of sailed through there, you know, and I think that was down to good songwriting, you know, and tight trousers.
Anti-trousers. Yeah. Trousers, I think you might have helped their case as well, Marty, to be perfectly
honest. Yeah, but the
fact
as well that you're blessed with that voice.
Well, you know, and to be fair, you know, I love my singing, you know, and I always did. And I think that was because my mum and dad nurtured that, more so my mum, you know, because to be involved in the arts. Because that was, you know, that's something that's that I think should be nurtured in it.
Yeah, of course. But with all the highs, Marty, there were a few lows, and I think it's very important that you're extremely open about addiction and about the darker days, because there's no doubt every time you have a conversation on a national radio show or a TV show like this, you're helping someone.
Well, you know, I do get nervous speaking about it because I want, because it is such a big part of my life, and you want to be eloquent about it, and you want to get your point about, across about it. When I started my journey of sobriety and got knowledge about my disease, then I could act on that and move forward. Mm-hmm. I'm 20 years sober now, and you know, the same madness still happens, but I choose not to drink. Hey, I'm the designated driver.
Right.
Do you know,
on
that's
an ongoing
basis.
Are the battles still there, Marty? Do you still have to fight it? Is it every day?
Well, I think it's something that you acknowledge. I think like anything, any fight that you have in your life or an understanding of your disease, because it's a disease, and it isn't just pertinent to people in my walk of life.
Yeah, that's every walk of life.
That's the beauty of this. It touches people from a housewife to even someone like a bricklayer or whatever.
Yeah, you don't have to be a pop star
It's not picky who it wants to hang out with. And I think as it unfolds, the smaller it gets and the more you get to address it and the understanding of it. And that's the key.
When you were talking about your mum earlier on and her nurturing of your voice and your pursuit of a career in the arts, was it always a goal then to end up on stage in terms of musical theatre? Was that something that you'd always wanted to do?
No, because I was doing a gig at the Albert Hall for Pete Townsend and Roger Daltrey. They have this wonderful charity for teenage cancer for the kids. And they asked me, come along, sing some songs. Now, I can do that all day long, you know? And I was singing on the stage and there was Ruthie Henshaw had just come back from Broadway. She's a West End actress, beautiful singer. And I said, come on up and sing some songs with me, Ruthie. And we were singing some songs and there was a couple of producers in the audience from Chicago.
And they went,
you know what, he'd make a great Billy Flynn. And I went and saw the Candor and Ebb show and fell in love with the score and the music.
Yeah, it's a great show.
And I thought, you know what, with the right help and a bit of hard work, I can pull this off. So much so I found myself in Broadway, just standing there. And I went the night before to watch a wee guy screwing in the bulbs. Is that sad?
No,
it's not.
Sad.
That's sad.
Because I remember
that gives you goosebumps.
I was telling my mammy and her sister, Gladys, they were sitting at the kitchen table, and I said, Mam, I'm going to do this thing, Chicago, the musical. She turned to me and she looked at me and she said, you're going to go to Broadway? That's what she said to me, and God bless her, she was right. And I thought, no, what are you doing? Because I remember sitting on the couch watching the MGM Classics on a Saturday afternoon.
Yeah, singing
and I would go to the pub,
and
me sitting on the couch, she'd get a wee fries, she liked a fries cream. A wee fries cream and a wee bag of sweeties.
Fries cream chocolate,
of sweeties for the pick and mix for me, and we'd sit and watch these MGM movies.
Listen, tell us very quickly about the new song and what people can expect to see at the 2 dates you're doing at the Bord Gáis.
Well, I'm coming over here. I'm doing a show, and it's called The Private Collection. It's just songs that have touched me through the years. Songs from old songs, new songs, borrowed songs. So I want to shoot the breeze with the audience, talk a wee bit about what the music is about, what it means to me. Have a good time. If it's an audience up for a dance, then I'll play loads of dance songs. If it's singer-songolders,
but they will be expecting the old stuff as well, and they'll definitely get that, won't they?
Well, I think it's important because I think you come to be entertained, not to be educated, a certain way. So there's a wee bit of educating going on and a wee bit and a whole lot of entertaining going on, and you might walk away knowing me a wee bit better. To me, that's my idea of a good night out, you know? And I must say, I'm also playing Limerick. You never mentioned that I was playing Limerick.
Belfast, Dublin.
Aye. I thought, have you got something against Limerick?
We have it coming up here in this edition.
We are very pro Limerick.
Here's me thinking that I thought I was working with professionals here.
I've played Limerick.
You are busking your way. I'm putting my glasses back on now because I'm intelligent.
He's getting serious.
I've got my glasses on.
My mum just sent me a text, by the way, saying, will you give Marty Pello a kiss for me?
Well, you know, listen,
And she never texts.
Yeah, but, she wants me to do it.
Oh, but she wants me to do it.
I'm going to show me that in a minute. Come on. This is for Anne, my mum. Yeah. Come on. Not for me at all.
Oh, that's lovely.
Let's sit over here.
Come on, son. Don't be shy.
You're left out, aren't you?
Come on. Let it out.
Right, come on.
Come on. Come on.
Go easy now.
That's all right.
Easy, son. That's all right. Let it out.
I understand your pain.
Terrible, nice fella.
And if you can get it, if you can get the frying pan on for the
don't
next
worry,
time,
I'll do
I
it
shot,
now.
For God's sake,
now look at
this.
Look, Marty will be performing the Private Collection tour on the waterfront in Belfast, the 10th of October, at Limerick's University Concert Hall on Friday the 12th, and Dublin's Borgosh Energy Theatre on Saturday the 13th. Ticket details are on Ticketmaster.
Marty Pellow, an absolute
pleasure. Thanks, Marty.
No, Thank you for coming in.
I thoroughly enjoyed myself.
I knew I'd end up sitting on his lap. I practically
did. You did, yeah.
After the break, I'm back on the catwalk with more cosy casual.
I feel like a gooseberry sitting over here. Look.
I know. Hey, maybe look at this
picture.
It's
like going back to my teenage years.
Look at this picture. It kind of works.
Yeah, I think you should hear
that. Aye. That's showbiz, though.
I know.
That is showbiz.
Yeah, yeah. Whatever.
Drops like a hot snot.
Whatever. Go to a break.
Thank you.